All right. Who you are, Peter's out there?
Rock and roller.
Haha, classic.
All you Orange Peelers out there, another song here up along the Thames Coast, the beautiful Thames Coast on this beautiful sunrise. It's about 7:30 in the morning. The sun's gleaming through those trees, piercing my eyes. It's pretty bright and it's golden. Love it. Down the north end of the Thames Coast. That's right, right down the end, up from Wilson's Bay. You travel up the hills, you get to the top lookout here. This is awesome. I've always been meaning to come and do a song here. So this is Mr. Neil Neil Orange Peel here. Rock and roll, a peeler needle with me, all you Orange Peelers. I'm going to try and do my New Zealand song, one of my New Zealand crazy songs, iconic, just to say a few cool things about New Zealand that we know, so many things. Obviously, you could go on forever, but here's a few in this song. Hopefully, Mr. Orange Peel does it all right. Well, have you heard about New Zealand means Newfoundland? Aotearoa, land of the long white cloud. We got the surf and the sand, and now we're away to the east or the west for a beach to play. Now there's 4.5 million people around. There's 30 million sheep making us proud. Now those sheep come in peace with their wool and their food. Hey, there's 30 million cows making us milk. Well, you check it out. I'm not sure how many cows there are. That's right. There's 4 million cups of coffee or tea. Well, thereabouts, approximately every day, consumed by New Zealanders. Well, that's a guess too, because I made it up. There's a population of 4.5 million in New Zealand. So, you work it out. It's just one of those things we want you Orange Peelers to go and research and think about. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate, so good. Yeah, nah, with Kiwis all good. Sweet as mate. G'day, mate. Long time no see. How are you? Cool. Oh, yeah, excellent. Would you like a cup of tea, mate? Oh, choice, mate. How would you have it? Milk, no sugar? Oh, sweet as milk, no sugar? Yeah, got it. Yeah, nah. Hang around, mate. It's all good. Sweet as mate. Yeah. Oh, what was that? Milk, two sugars. Milk, no, milk, two sugars, eh? That, oh, no, milk, no sugar. Sweet as, sorry, mate, all good, got it. Yeah, no, it's all good. Sweet as mate, all good, sweet as mate. We got the best rugby team the world has ever seen. You know who I'm talking about, you know who I mean. Well, say it again, can you tell me out loud? It's the... Did I hear you say All Blacks? Now that's what I mean, yeah. Now it was Sir Edmund Hillary truly conquered the world. He put New Zealand on top with a flag and a pole. He was the first man to climb the biggest mountain in the world. What mountain was that called? Or is that called? What is that mountain? Starts with E. Go and look it up. The highest mountain in the world. Tallest. Now, Sir Edmund Hillary's name lives forever and always will. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate. Good Kiwis, eh? Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate. It's all good. Sweet as mate. Hey, but what about the lady on our $10 note? That's right. Her name starts with K. For Kate, yes. It's not Kate Blanchett. She was Lord of the Rings actress. She's an English actress from Lord of the Rings. I loved it. And she was like the white Elvish queen, eh? Okay. Not Kate Blanchett, no, for sure. It is the lady on the $10 note for New Zealand with her hair in a bun. In 1893, made something happen for the woman. It was the votes, wasn't it? She got women the votes by campaigning, protesting that women deserved the votes. And so true. So good on you, Kate Shepherd. 1893, women's suffrage. Look it up. Google. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate, it's all good. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate, it's all good. Sweet as mate. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, I love my kiwi roast, my lamb and pork chops. Good old kiwi hungy. Pork and poo hub all up. My mum makes the best pavlova in the world. Oh, what about her lamb roast with the homemade gravy and the homemade mint sauce on the kumaras and on the roasted potato and on the roasted pumpkin. Oh, and the beautiful peas all there. Oh, yeah. Love your mum. And all your mums out there, I bet Nan's pops, uncles, aunties are probably the best cooks, and you know it, the ones who look after you and make you the food. It's great. Tribute to them, mate. And now it's all good. Sweet as my childhood. And Mum and Dad, thank you for letting us watch Billy T. James back in the day. Billy T. James back in the day is the funniest man on our TV screens. He had the laugh to be like this. He was the funniest man that just cracked us up. He was the best. Now, he's still actually, he's still being viewed on Māori television. Look it up. Billy T. James, funny as, and he's just the best. And he's unfortunately, he's passed on now, and he's buried at Mount Taupiri, I believe. And God bless him. And listen, yeah, thank you, Mum and Dad, for letting us watch. Now, didn't he write that song, Poor Year? Poor Year. Poor Year. No. Trick. It was Dalvanius and the Pātea Māori Club in 1984. A number one hit in New Zealand that was for 6 weeks on the New Zealand charts. Shot! Pātea Māori Club and Dalvanius. Look up Dalvanius too, you probably don't know. He was a Māori entertainer, very similar to Billy T. James, sort of. Okay, so anyway, yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mate, it's all good. Sweet as mate, here comes a big rig. Here's a huge big rig. Whatever he's going to do there. Shot! Orange peelers rock! That's it. It was an awesome big rig, that one. Now, where were we? Yeah, nah, so good. Sweet as mine, so good. Sweet as mine. Beautiful day up here. Now, well, what about? I love my Kiwi jandals and the hot summer sand. I'm not wearing them, obviously. Got my shoes on right now. My New Zealand buzzy bee, I always take it for a swim. I got red band gumboots for mowing my lawns. Not wearing those either at the moment, but I got a pair at home. Red band gumboots for mowing my lawn. A number 8 wire holding up my overalls. That's right, DIY, do it yourself, eh? Good Kiwis. DIY, abbreviation, do it yourself. Number 8 wire holding up my overalls. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as mine. We're Kiwis, mate. We might get it wrong the first, second time, maybe the third, fourth, but we'll try and fix it up and we'll keep on going until we get it. Yeah. Now, but guess what about my Massport mower that's underneath my house? Rusted, chip paint, rough as. See, that classic, the old Massport mower. And yeah, it's got the old piece of rope coming out of it and a piece of old wood tied on the top in a knot to pull as the cord. And you put, first pop, she goes. Good old mess, put one. With the old rope and piece of wood for hand to hold. Classic. Boom. Exaggeration on going first pop. Goes after about 5 goes. Boom. Boom. Pump it, pump the petrol. Boom. 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 We're away. I love my moves. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as May. It's all good. We're Kiwis, but it's May. That's right, we're Kiwis and we keep on trying, keep on rocking, keep on orange peeling. That's what we do. But what about that beautiful bird in our New Zealand beautiful bushland? Goes like this. Something like that. Did you say the tui? You're right, the one with the beautiful white pouches underneath its chin. Yeah, beautiful tui. The passing bird, I believe tui means something to that effect. It's beautiful, that's right. Is it that bird that sings that song and had it originally? Well, I read a book that it was the bellbird that is original with that tune, and the tui copies other birds, particularly the bellbird song. But I still believe the tui was first. I don't know. You go and read and research. And that's a good thing to do when you're not sure on facts. Check it out. Go to your library. They're awesome places to study and look up with your dad, your nans, your pops, your aunties, uncles, your mums, so on, big sisters, big brothers. Go and look it up and get into the computer too. But it's always good going to those libraries and checking that stuff out and asking people. Yeah, because which one is it? The bellbird or the tui? I don't believe that tui was first, its original song. But it probably copies other birds. So, you read, read up and see what you think. Yeah, nah, it's all good anyway. Sweet as May, she's all good. Yeah, nah, it's all good. Sweet as May, it's all good. Yeah, sweet as May. And you know those big billboards? Those, yeah, right billboards? Ironically, they're Tui. Well, it should be Mr. Nene Orangefield billboards. Billboards. Billboards, did I say? Or billboards. Maybe billboards. And, yeah, nah, it's all good, sweet as maid. On this. So, yeah, that's my crazy song. And there's so much more about our cool New Zealand, our cool Newfoundland, Aotearoa, Newfoundland. Was it Abel Tasman who named it that? New Zealand or Zealandia-Novia? The explorer, Abel Tasman, 1642 maybe? Wow, you could look that up. And was it Kupe, the Māori legend, who sat up in his waka as they paddled from Hawaiki over 1,000 years ago? And did he name, did Kupe name it Aotearoa as he saw the land in the distance, in the horizon? On the horizon, covered by a huge, long, white cloud. And did he stand up and say, Aotearoa, land of the long, white cloud? And was he following a shining cuckoo in his waka? Or did the cuckoo lead him to the land, or show him there was land? Or was it the legend he chased, Te Whiki, the giant octopus across the Pacific Ocean from Hawaiki, that he found and discovered Aotearoa? You're not so good. Have a look up at these things. Search them up. Yeah, rock on, you Orange Peelers. Hope you enjoyed that. That's one of my New Zealand sort of crazy Mr. Neil Neil Orange Peel songs. Celebrating our country up here on the Thames Coast. We're up the north end of the Thames Coast. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful with the sunrise. Hope it's glaring. It's very bright. But anyway, we'll do some more songs. Peel out. Peel out all your Orange Peelers. Rock and roll it. Peel it in. Stay tuned.
Come on. Hopefully they recorded something. Come on. Got it. And there. Oh, I love it. Love it.